kinesiologist living in Llansilio in Pembrokeshire. I've been here about 23 years. I'm from London originally, and met my husband in Wimbledon School of Art, where I did a degree in theatre, film, props, that kind of thing, and worked in London doing that for a while. And then Kit and I moved to Pembrokeshire after our first daughter was born and set up a home and work here. He's a sculptor, so we very much focused on that, and I focused on being mum and supporting him in his business. And then further down the line, I realised I'd always been drawn to an alternative approach to health and well-being, and started to look around for what it was that I wanted to do, what I was drawn to, and found kinesiology. So I trained at that, and I've been practicing as a kinesiologist, a systematic kinesiologist, for 8 years now. Eight years. I'm also recently qualified as a QEC practitioner. Having been brought up in the city, and when I first moved to Pembrokeshire, it was an idea of the kind of lifestyle that I would have and the kind of how country living would be. And of course, an idea is never quite as the reality is. So it took quite a while for me to really establish myself here. But now, my relationship with the land and the local area is so important to me. And during this lockdown, I've really found that my relationship with my very local area and the local beach and so on has really deepened and is a huge benefit to my well-being. And I feel really connected to it. So my favourite place in Pembrokeshire changes and shifts. I think I love going down to Barrowfundle Bay. That's important to me. It's a beautiful place, it's a beautiful walk. I've got lots of memories with the family there. But recently in lockdown, our local beach, which I would kind of drive past, Amroth, was just not the place that I would choose to go unless I had to take the dog for a quick walk or something. But now I've got a very different relationship with Amroth. So in a way, Amroth has become one of my favourite places to hang out, because I've got so many lovely memories with meeting up with a friend and spending time just being by the water. And it shifts and changes to what's happening in my life, I suppose. When I first got here and I went to the Queen's Hall, I couldn't believe how there was every generation there, all having an amazing time, all together, totally in harmony with each other, just getting on with it. And amazing bands, best nights I've ever had have been in the Queen's Hall, and there's many of them. It's always just such a great vibe. I love to dance. I absolutely love dancing. So it's just so fantastic to really let your hair down. Fantastic bands, fantastic vibe. Everybody's dancing immediately. There's no kind of hanging around being cool. Everybody's up and dancing. You dance with the kids, you dance with the people who are older. And I suppose we don't have that much choice. There's not loads of places to go. So it's when there's a good band, everybody goes and everybody's determined to have a great time, and they do. And then everybody talks about it afterwards. It's just a really valuable place. And having two girls that have grown up and in this place, the Queen's Hall has been such a valuable place where there's first nights where they go out and maybe they have a few drinks, and we can be there. We're not, in the shadows. Our friends are around, people are around, everybody knows them, but we're not crowding them. And it was just a really lovely stepping stone for them to be going out, but also feeling like they're sort of safe in that, they're held in that to a point. And it was as a parent, it was I was extremely grateful for that. And then at the end of the night, we always end up dancing with the girls and having a lot of fun. So great memories. I'm really grateful to Queen's Hall for all of the memories.